Hello again. So, it's the 20th of March 2014, and it's been a year now since I had my ears pointed. And as promised, here's the question and answer video. So, to start us off, the MCR Charlotte asked two questions. The first being, can you get a scaffold piercing with pointed ears? I'm not entirely sure of the answer to that. I would imagine it depends on your anatomy once the pointing is healed. Because sometimes they will heal and the actual helix rim would be too shallow. In my case, the right ear would be. I'm not sure if you'd be able to see, but it would be way too shallow to get an industrial piercing there. And not have it reject. The left ear, I'm not entirely sure of, being honest. There's a bit more there. There's a bit more of a bit more flesh there. But again, whether or not I'd be able to get one without it rejecting, I honestly don't know. I would imagine with the other method there would be a little bit more room to play with. But I honestly don't know. Like I say, the only thing I can suggest is if you do get your ears pointed and you want an industrial piercing afterwards, to wait for them to heal at least 6 months, I think it was, if not, preferably a year, and visit a piercer and ask them, to check out your anatomy, and they'll tell you whether or not it's doable. And secondly, are you planning on getting your tongue split? If so, when? I would like to get my tongue split still, but the healing would be a pain for me because, to my knowledge, you're only able to eat things like extremely weak vegetable soup, and I have an extreme aversion to vegetables, so it could be a little bit more challenging for me to heal a tongue split than other people that are able to eat vegetables. So again, that would be something I'd have to ask about and get more information on as and when the time comes. At the moment, I haven't really been thinking about it all that much. Aside from tattoo work, I haven't been thinking about any modifications all that much. So, as and when the time comes, I will let you know. Just as a disclaimer, which I probably should have said at the beginning of the video, some of these questions are from the last time I appealed for questions for a Q&A video, but I only had about three, so, well, two that were relevant, one that was not relevant to anything. So some of those will be carried over, like the tongue split question and the following question. Kelly Winchester asked, what body modification would you never ever consider getting done, or do you have no limits? The only modification I would never consider getting done would be anything to do with my eyes because it goes through me. The effect of having your eyeballs tattooed, it looks amazing. I'm sure people have seen, and probably people have polarizing views on that, but to me it looks absolutely amazing. I would never get it done because of the actual process. Seeing the needle moving closer and closer to your eye. No, sorry. I can't. No, it just goes through me. I'm not too keen on eyebrow piercings, just for myself. I mean, if someone else wants to get it done, more power to them. I would never look down on someone for something that they did unless it was harmful to someone else. But yeah, eyebrow piercings, not a fan of. I guess that's about it, actually. There's not many that I would never consider getting done. I guess branding, maybe. I don't know. I can't say I've thought about it all that much. I'm pretty much open to anything, other than the eyeball stuff. Because, I get a modification because I feel I need to do it. So if I feel I need to do something, I will most likely get it done. And I only really think about something as and when I feel like I need to do it. So, yeah, a bit of a strange answer, I will admit. Okay, Hyperpipe on Tumblr asks quite a lot of questions actually. First off, do many people seem to notice or react? Honestly, no. Not when passing in the street, because the way I had it done, it looked so natural that people just don't really notice when they're passing me in the street and what have you. When it is pointed out to them, generally speaking, the reaction has been quite positive. I haven't had any stupid comments or anything like that. I did have a comment on one YouTube video asking, was I gonna be making presents for Christmas? Like a good little elf. But other than that, and that might have just been a troll, I'm not sure. Whatever, it is what it is. What is their usual response? Like I say, it's usually pretty positive. The only one thing I have had is a couple of things with like, well, it barely notices, and you spent all that much money, and I went through all that for very little change, and it's people. A lot of people in that regard, they don't understand that it's a process that is basically an optical illusion. It creates the illusion that your ear is slightly taller because it's thinner, but you don't actually. It's impossible to add something to the ear. You can only take it away. And I think a lot of people, when I was saying I was going to have my ears pointed, they were thinking that they'd be sort of up here, a lot longer and taller and more of a point kind of thing because something would be added to. But once it's explained, they're generally satisfied. And my general reaction to that is, yeah, well, it was for me, not for you, kind of thing, Any regrets? No. Aside from one. The only regret I have is not getting it done sooner because it made me feel so much better about myself. And it sounds like a weird thing to do, but like I say, once I found out that, I mean, I knew that people could do it, but I didn't think there was anyone in Britain that did it. And as soon as I found out that someone in the UK actually did the procedure, it was kind of, I have to do this. Because otherwise I was thinking I'd have to get over to America to have it done, and it was just too much for me to do at the time. Still is, being perfectly honest with you. So, and finally, any additional wisdom or transcendental revelations or magic powers? Sadly, no. But anyone that knows me in real life knows I'm fairly philosophical anyway because I have way too much time to think. So I guess you could count that if you really wanted to. And the only thing I would say is if you are planning on having your ears done, research it as much as possible and don't just jump into it. Like I say, most good artists will not allow you to just jump into it anyway. They will make sure that it's the right thing for you and they will talk you through it and through all the pros and cons for quite a while. I was talking to Ronnie Lashowitz for at least a year on and off before I had it done. So, just be mindful of that, basically. Mike asked, what are people in the bodymodding community like? Generally speaking, they are really nice, really open-minded, and generally pretty down to earth, being perfectly honest with you. I haven't met anyone that wasn't like that when I was, a part of the bodymodding community on Facebook. I'm not so much these days, and there are reasons for that I'm not going to go into in this video. But, some could argue that towards the end it was probably me that was the one that wasn't too nice, but I was going through a lot at the time. And, let people have their opinions of me that they want. It's neither here nor there to me. But like I say, genuinely speaking, they're really nice people. And basically, if you respect them, they will respect you. It's as simple as that, Like I say, and I suppose every group and subculture and what have you, no matter how positive they are, they're gonna have people that are a bit more militant, I suppose. But generally speaking, in the body modification community, I've not seen that. Finally, I had two anon questions on Tumblr, and the first was fave and least fave piercings. My favourite piercing is probably the septum and the lip, lower lip, because they seem to just fit everyone. I don't know what it is about them, but no matter what your facial structure is, if you get a septum piercing or a lip piercing, it will not look out of place. At least I've yet to see one that looks out of place on someone. I mean, there's exceptions to every rule, but generally speaking, I've not seen one that just looks wrong. I also really love industrial piercings or scaffold piercings, where they pierce, and you have a bar across your ear. And as I said in the video earlier, I would really like to have one. Wait, did I say it in the video? I can't remember. I'd really like to have one done again, but it depends on my anatomy. So I'll have that checked out. Other than that, I would probably say stretch ears as well. I really like stretch ears for whatever reason. Least favorite piercings, probably the eyebrow, but that probably came from when I was growing up. There are people that I generally would not want to associate with from around my area that were having their eyebrows pierced when I was about 10 years old, and literally all of them were doing it. It was like some weird craze for about a year that everyone was having their eyebrow piercing that everyone was having their eyebrow pierced that were part of this group that I wouldn't want to associate with now, nor at the time, but I was too young at the time. So that may have had an impact there. And I'm also not too keen on, is it Monroe piercings they call them? Where you have either side of your lip pierced or both, which I think are called angel bites. I don't know why it is, I'm just not keen on it, but philtrum is fine. I really like philtrum piercings. But I don't know. For some reason, anything on the top lip that's pierced, I'm not too keen. I mean, again, if you want to have it done, more power to you. I'm not going to stop you or judge you for having it done. It's just not something that I really like and would have done myself. But again, exceptions to every rule. There are people that look amazing with them, so it all depends, and I don't know what it depends on, but yeah. And finally, why the hell did you want to point your ears? Basically, because it was something I felt I needed to do to be happier with myself, and I proved myself right when I had it done. I seen people have it done on Tumblr and people that had it done on Tumblr. And it really appealed to me, but I figured it was something you would have to go to America to do. And then I found out that there were practitioners in the UK, body modification practitioners, that would do it. And that was it. It was just kind of, I have to do this and I have to do this soon. And it took me a year to do it. But I've not regretted it and I don't think I ever will. So, yeah. Thanks to everyone that submitted questions, and thank you for watching, and I guess I'll see you whenever the next video may be. I'm not sure when. So, yay! Take care, all.